to Pia Jakobsen. Pia, a special welcome. I'm very happy to have you. Also, not only, but gender balance in our sector is not always so good. We have to work on that as well. So I'm very happy that we have also a female voice here, in particular representing an important company like Viking Energy. And I'm very pleased to give you the floor to speak about your company's strategy and how you want to compete on the market and make the strong the wind, small wind industry stronger. Pia, the floor is
I
yours.
will do that, and I will share my screen. And let's see, it must be this one. Can you see my screen now?
Yes.
Perfect.
If you go on presentation mode, then.
Yeah, I will just go to presentation mode. It will come here.
Super.
And I will make a short presentation of Viking Wind. We are a small company located in Denmark, and as you know, everyone need to have wind. It's the one of the fastest growing energy in the world. And as you can see here, the owners of Viking Wind was started in 2009 by an auto mechanic and an engineer. And they founded it as in April 2009, and we got the first type approval in May 2011. And that shows how difficult it is to get a type approval for your turbine, and it's very important to get this type approval. And then in 2014, they reduced the owner to from six to two owners, and the new owner group consists of our managing director Ulrik Høenhaven and an investor who is invest in small business where he can see the potential to grow. And in 2017, we had to rebrand because our former name was HS Wind, and we consider it was very difficult to pronounce when you come out to the world. So we decided to get a new name, and it was Viking Wind. And all employees here by Viking Wind has a long career from wind turbine. And we come from Vestas, Siemens and Suzlon, and we have been in all of the companies. And then we go back to basic to small wind turbines. And our core business is to produce high quality wind turbines with tilt towers. And we just want to have an output up to 25 kilowatts. And this is our company profile, as you see, and we are four full-time employees and two part-time employees. And we have installed 67 turbines worldwide. I will start with the foundation because it's also a very important issue when you have to make a wind turbine, because this foundation don't use a lot of land, and it's very important if you go to rural areas where they are dependent of to harvest the chops. So we have designed it with that, and we also have lots of opportunities to our turbine, but I will come back to it. And it's also easy to install and maintain, as you can see. It's designed to easy transportation, and it's very important if we go outside Denmark, so we can have three complete turbines in a 40-foot container, and the heaviest lift is 1 ton. And we have a winch, so we can erect the turbine with the winch, and we also use it when we have a maintain and when we make service on the turbine, so all work can be performed from the ground. And when from lay down from start to end, it only takes 15 minutes, so it's quite fast to do it. And if you come to a typhoon areas, it's important you can lay your turbine very fast. As you can see, our turbine is type approved according to IEC 61400, and that is so it meet all the international standard, and it was mentioned before, it's very important to choose a turbine with this type approval, because then you know we have spent a lot of money to get this type approval. It's not just one you get. You have to have all your documentation ready, and you have to do everything ready for to get this type approval. That is what our turbine can produce. It's a yearly energy production. It depends on the wind speed. And that is what all customers says. It's always windy here by my side. But as everybody knows, no, it's not sure. It's so windy. So it's very important to know exactly what the wind speed is on site. And I have a comment for this wind speed. I use a tool who is free for everyone. It's called mywindturbine.com. And it's easy to use, and there is a free basic tools, and then you can pay 59 euro, and then you can get the full, there is obstacle and everything in that tools. And here can you see that is just, that is a real wind turbine from one of our customer. And yes, that is always what we discuss with the customer. We cannot decide how much the wind blow, how windy it is every year. So you can see at the left side is there's very different output from the turbine. We have also surveillance. So we have surveillance on all our turbines. So we have track on them here in Denmark. So we can always be on track is how windy it is. Are there anything wrong? Has the customer stopped the turbine because he think, oh, I don't want to listen to my turbine today? Or there's a lot of reasons. So we can see exactly and call them, and they can call us, and we can go in and look to the turbine and see what is if there should be any problem. But of course, we also mentioned gear oil, is it everything can we see on this? And it's the same here. We also offer off-grid solution. This is a picture from Argentina, where we installed three turbines in 2013 with success. That is a hybrid solution. There is a diesel generator and there is hydro in this project, and it's exactly the same. They call us if they have problem, and we have educated the technician on site to maintain these turbines. So we don't have to go out and maintain them, but they still keep the 1 yearly service on the turbines because it's very important to keep this. Then we also have an off-grid project here in Denmark. There is a small island. It's a special island because it's not connected to the mainland at all. And it's a holiday resort. It's a luxury holiday resort, and they have greenhouses, they have they produce organic food, and it's like that 16 to 20 people are employed full time to take care of all the guests and the resorts. And they have saved about 1 million Danish kroner per year when they started this solution. There is a battery, there is solar and wind. And we have a power management system to keep on track on this. And we have supplied them with two turbines. And it was a little fast presentation, and thank you for listening to this.
Thank you very much, Pia. That was, a good overview, wonderful overview, how your company managed to get on the market. Certainly at the time that was also not so easy, because the time when we heard from your colleagues, but there was exactly. Already it's quite strong pressure.
And I have the same experience with the Chinese. It's not my best friends. It's so tough to compete with them.
Actually, what we also wanted to have a speaker from China, because we were working, of course, also with our Chinese colleagues. And they this time could not participate. But let me mention, as you showed wind turbines in Argentina, and if I'm right here, I look at the list of participants, we have the president, the new president of the Argentine Wind Energy Association here with us, Hector Pagani. A special welcome to Argentina. So there's certainly some
oh yeah, certainly
ways to say hello to each other.
Absolutely.
As it's anyway always a pleasure to have a very international audience here. So thank you, Pia.